All right, hello once again. This is Jeff Scott of Rankin Technical College, and as part of the Rankin Technical College AWD 1000 Web Development Technologies course, I've been creating a series of video presentations that are based on the Mozilla Developer Network Learn Web Development series. I am in the JavaScript portion of this, and we are now talking about the JavaScript building blocks. And this particular section, as you can see, is called Making Decision in Your Code Conditionals. And as mentioned, virtually any programming language will support some version of conditional statements. All right. Conditional statements, as it says right there, allow us to represent such decision making in JavaScript. Things like the choice which must be made, the outcome of those choices, etc. Now, let's just take a look at a really, really simple example. So I can come in here and I can say something like, let's create a variable that's called age. All right. So we'll create this variable and we'll give it an initial value of 17. Okay. And then let's just suppose in here, I'm going to put dot, 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 meaning there's some code in there. I don't know what it is. I don't care what it is. But if I come through here and I say this, if age greater than equal to 18, alert, you can vote. Now, hopefully, regardless of the amount of experience you have with this stuff, you can look at this and know, well, that person is not greater than or equal to 18. So what's going to happen here? And the answer is nothing. This is a simple if statement that has no else. All right, so if this is true, you do it. Otherwise, you do nothing. Now, if I wanted to, I could come in here and do something like this. And let's change the message in here to you are old enough to vote. And this will say you are, how about this, are not old enough to vote. And this will say you are. All right. Now, in this case, the person is 17. Is 17 greater than or equal to 18? No. So this gets skipped and this gets hit. All right. Now, that's an if else. So again, when we had just this, it was an if statement. All right. And once we, you know, that just meant that if the if part was true, we did what came within the curly braces. Since there's only one line there, the curly braces are not even mandatory. All right. And then adding this said that if this is true, you will do this. Otherwise, you will skip this and you will do this. So the key takeaway right here is if you've got an if else, you either must do what's inside of the if block or you must do what's inside of the else block. Now let's look at one more example. We'll put here let number equal 23, okay? And I'm going to put in here if number equal 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 0, I'm going to put in here an alert that says 0 is neither positive nor negative. All right. And then I'm going to say here, else, let's see. If, we'll just do it this way. There's plenty of ways to do this, but I'm just going to show you a way of doing it. Else if number modulo 2 equal, equal, equal 0. And I'm going to steal this. Whoops, I guess I stole too much. And this, well, I didn't steal it at all. What the heck did I do here? There we go. So let me grab that. And we're going to say, we're going to use our template literal that we talked about before. The number, dollar sign number, is positive. Positive. All right. And again, we'll have to put our template literal in there. I'm going to say else, if it's equal to 1, the number is, in fact, it's not even positive. This is even, this is odd, and this is even, and this is odd. And then I'm finally going to put in here else, alert. You must have entered a non-numeric input. All right, so let's take a look at this whole thing here. So this number here is 23. So it's going to come in and it's going to check, is the number up there, was it 23? Well, it's not. So we're going to skip this. So we won't use that, say that alert statement. Then we'll take the number and we'll divide it by 2 and see if there is no remainder. 23 divided by 2 is 11, but it has a remainder of 1. So that's not going to be hit. So we're going to skip this. But when we do take 23 and we modulo it by 2, all right, it does have a remainder of 1. So it's going to write down the number 23 is odd. Now, had we come in here and done this, let number equals 6, which would have been silly, but you get the idea. Well, it's not 0, and it's not divisible by 2 evenly or not evenly, so it should come in here and say, you must have entered a non-numeric input. Now, there's plenty of other ways that we can test this. All right, probably a cleaner way than what I just showed you would have been to do something like this. I could have come in at the beginning and said, if is not a number, so if it was not numeric, all right, then we could have come in here and said, this alert that we had right here. So we could have said, you must have entered a non-numeric input, okay? And then we could have just said return, because there's no sense in going on any further. All right, so we don't need an else here. So we could still keep everything that we had here, but, okay, if it's 0, it's not odd or even. Otherwise, and we could still actually leave this in here. We could still put in an else and put in an alert, like bad input. That should never actually be hit, but start playing computer because that's what you have to do to be successful here. So in this case, the number is the word 6. So we put in here 6 like this. So it's a string, which is non-numeric. So if is not a number, so that's going to be true. It should come in and say you have entered a non-numeric input and it should return. If it gets down to here, so let's put a couple comments in here. Check for non-numeric input. All right. Input was numeric. All right. So we know that. Check for input value of 0. Some people will argue and say 0 is even. I don't really care, but you get the idea. All right. Check if number, I will say input value because I said that up here. So check if input value is even. This will check if the input, this will check to see if the input value is odd. And this should handle any other case. I'm going to put down here, should never be hit. All right. So looking at this simply here, try to put all of it on, up on the screen at once so you can see every bit of it. Come on. There we go. All right. So what are we doing? We are first checking in this case for non-numeric. This is a simple if. If this is true, we will do this and we're not going to do anything else. If we get down to here, we know it was numeric. So we come in here and we check if the number that we input, so if this was zero, then that alert's going to be true, and we're going to skip all of this. If the number we put in was 10, it's not zero, so we skip this. 10 divided by 2 has no remainder, so that'll be true. So it'll say the number 10 is even. On the other hand, if we put in this, all right, that won't happen. It is numeric. It's not zero. It's not divisible by evenly by 2, but it is divisible by 2 with a remainder of 1, so it should put 11 is odd. This is kind of a default or a catch-all case, but really it should never even be hit. All right. Now, I'm already up enough in time, so I want to show you one more thing before we go on in here. So I'm going to leave that one here. All right. And I'm going to go down a little further, and let's put it on another screen here. I'm going to grab this, paste it, but I'm going to make a lot of changes. So I'm going to have something here that's called size. So I'm going to say let size equal, and I'm going to put in here medium. Okay? All right. So now I'm going to come in here, and I'm going to do a switch on size. All right, so I'm going to do a switch. This will be like an if, but not exactly the same thing. So I'm going to say here, case, small, alert, size is a small, and break. Now, I'm going to steal a bunch of my code here, and I'm going to assume that the only sizes that are valid are small, medium, large, and extra large. That's what I'm assuming right there. All right, and this will say default. So if it's a small, we're going to say small. If it's a medium, we're going to say medium. If it's a large, we're going to say large. Oops. If it's in, let's just put here X large. All right, so if it's an X large, we're going to say X large. Otherwise, we're going to say size is unknown. All right, so let's play computer here. Pretty obvious. Since we set it to medium, it'll come down here and it'll say, was it small? No, so it'll skip this. So it'll say, is it medium? It is. Now, quite often when you work with this stuff and you're working with strings, there are string functions to make things uppercase, to make things lowercase. If you think, for example, that it's possible that they might put it in an uppercase, lowercase, mixed case, etc., I might come down here and in my code someplace I might type in size equals size dot to uppercase. All right. So now instead of looking like that, and you know, we'll have to check for these small, medium, large. And X large. And we'll even make this one large, big too, unknown. All right. So it works. We could have done this with an if. We could have said if size equal small, done this alert. Else if size equal medium, do this alert. Else if size equal large, do this alert. Else if size equal x large, do this alert. Else do this alert. So this works very much like a refined if statement. You need the break because the break gets you out of the switch. If you don't put the break in there, so let's say this wasn't there, and let's say it was a small. It would have said size is a small, then it immediately would have said size is a medium. All right, so this is yet another way that you can write selection statements. All right, so I just went over the basic if else. We'll come back and we'll take a look at it in just a minute, but I decided to break away a little bit and give you my own version as we get going in here.